slow it down for them, you know? Sometimes they say you gotta laugh. You might laugh to cry out. Oh, man. When you get time to relax? That's the question.
La música, you know what I'm saying?
Homie, I just lost.
What's up, you guys? What I have for you today? LeBron 11, blue, black gun. I'm Bonjoy, and let's get to this review. Alright, let's get to it with what you get if you buy these off of retail. It comes in this crimson red, black colorway, just like, you know, the LeBron 4s, you know what I'm saying? And this is what they come in. But let's get going with the shoe. At first glance, don't these shoes look pretty fresh? I'll be so safe for myself. But let's take a look at what we have for the black gums. We got an all black base all around the shoe. And at the bottoms, look at the sole, we got the gum. Those gum soles, pretty fresh. LeBron James logo in the bottom here. And this is what's cool about this shoe. You get an all black base with gum sole, but in the inner lining, you get some really cool tie-dye. That really looks loud, you know what I'm saying? Got your LeBron inside right there. So, got a dope shoe, man. Let's get into more details of what we have here. What we have here is the gum sole. And we can see some kind of chain pattern around where you should pivot your foot. And changes around the sides. And it's supposed to give you decent grip on the courts. For your midsole, you got a 360 airbag Air Max. And that should give you some extra cushioning when you're running and jumping. Above that would be some sort of rubber padding midsole to give you even more cushioning when it comes to running up and down and jumping down on the court. Take a look at your toe box here. Very sturdy, you know what I mean? It's really hard and has this matte finish, which is really nice. You got your Nike swoosh with some kind of swirl design. And it's also 3M. The lows also feature some foam faucet from the sides. So you also got that good supportive technology in there. In the back, you get this plastic padding on the heel, which should give you a lot of support. It's really sturdy, really strong. You know, overall the shoe looks really strong. You know, it's gonna last for a long time. You also got your Nike swoosh right here. I talked about this earlier, but let's go into it some more. You know, got that tie-dye lining in the inside. Super dope. You know, you got your Nike tag right there. You know, your insole is so soft when you put your foot in there. So it's a comfortable shoe too. And that's a plus for having shoes like these. We got your tongue, a LeBron James logo, some breathable design right here. Yeah, black laces, and at the tips you get these golden LeBron tips. It's pretty fresh. If you're not familiar with LeBron 11s, you get pretty much a lot for what you pay for. You know, you get the Air Max, you know, midsole, the foam posic technology. Very sturdy, very strong shoe. Now that we've gone over most of the shoe, let's go lace these up and see how they look on feet. Nikes on my feet keep my cypher complete. Bike in the Nikes on my feet keep my cypher complete. Bike in the Nikes on my feet keep my cypher complete. What's up, you guys? Decided to change and head back inside the house because it's like 100 degrees outside, and what I'm gonna do now is give you an overall review about the shoe and what I personally think about it. But then I know what you're thinking. Well, what about a performance test? And like, I don't do performance tests basically because you have to look at the shoe and know what you're buying and expect what you're gonna have. Because like, you're already buying, you know, foam posit technology, Air Max technology, and it's basically a balling shoe. You got your hard heel, hard toe box, you know, and take some expert advice from people who actually balled in these, you know, like people who been using these a lot, and you know, take a look at people who wear these in the NBA and see if they perform well, if they, you know, slip or not, if they grip on the court real good. You know, everybody balls differently, so check them out for yourself if you want to ball in these. I think they are a decent balling shoe because, like, you know, they're LeBrons, not just because they're one of LeBrons, but they're specifically made for balling, and I think they are a decent balling shoe, especially out of all the releases for Nike. Another thing too is that LeBrons are specifically made for LeBron, so if you're not like LeBron with the same, you know, feet as him, I wouldn't suggest getting these shoes to ball in. You know, you gotta have, you know, wide, thick feet like LeBron. You know, if you're narrow-footed like KD, you shouldn't really LeBron. You shouldn't really play in LeBron's. You should play in KD's. You know what I'm saying? So try to copy what I'm trying to say and take a look at people who, you know, really love the shoe and see if you could compare yourself to them so you could have your own expert opinion about the shoe. Overall, these shoes are really fresh, you know, a black base, gum sole with a really loud lining, and it's a dope shoe, man. I personally think it is. Having a black shoe, you could really just match with anything, and that's like, you know, the coolest thing about black shoes is that they could match with any outfit, and that's definitely a plus for these shoes. So I think you should cop these, you know, and these are really popular right now because these were the only pairs at the mall. And you can check online if you want, you know, ask your friends if you want to buy it off of them. Really, really good looking shoe. Get them. I'm Bunjoy, signing out. Peace.
Only limitations you ever have are those that you place upon yourself. Touch is definitely on the move, know what I'm talking about? Exercise your wisdom, it don't depend on no one else. Cathedral, church, ism.